baseball here on the show. Today, a spring training matchup between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Boston Red Sox. We've got baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Rich Hill gets the ball for the Red Sox in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, every team needs a pitcher like this one here. His numbers aren't going to blow you away. Career ERA just under 4. But one thing he does, he takes the ball every 5 days, throws strikes, and gives his team a chance to win every single time he goes out there. He'll be fun to watch in this one here today.
That brings up Wander Franco. And we are ready for some daytime baseball.
Wander Franco.
Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
First pitch, 106.
Looked like a breaking ball that time, but it never came back down. It's hot, but not too hot this afternoon, and even 90 degrees here at first pitch. 2-1 to the Rays leadoff batter. The 2-1 home.
Hey. We're going to count 2-2.
He stays alive, still 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here.
You can bet these hitters are taking note of what the guy on the hill is working with. A long at bat like this in the first inning can reveal a lot.
And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game.
That's a pretty sad attempt at hitting a baseball right there. No doubt he was completely fooled because that was a curveball and it looked like he was late on a curveball. That tells me he gave up on it right till the very end, and obviously there was nothing he could do at that point.
Randy Arozarena comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. In comes the center fielder, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out.
Batting third.
And here's the starting lineup for the visiting Tampa Bay Rays. Thoughts, Dan, who stands out?
Matty, I'm really excited to see Randy Arozarena in this one.
I was talking about him earlier with some people, and I kept telling him he's got some really good speed. If you watch him in this game, he's the type of guy, he's not going to shock you with his speed, but he can make an impact with his legs. We'll see if he gets that chance.
And he is in to third with a two-out triple.
Check out the lefty as he absolutely jumps on that first pitch and hammers it to right. Got what he was looking for and put a good swing on it.
Zunino.
Here now is Mike Zunino. As he'll take a look at a strike right down the middle, it's 0-1. Trying to cash in here in his first at bat with a runner at third and two gone. A ball and a strike to Mike Zunino.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Line drive to left. Martinez is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. No damage done after the two-out triple. It's on to the bottom of the first. No score on the show. Shane McClanahan, a left-handed Floridian, will get the starting assignment. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Well, Matt, the first thing we're going to find out is how well this guy pitches with little sleep. I can't imagine knowing that you're going to be the next day starting pitcher the night before. This is a young guy making his first start. Listen, you can only make your debut one time, so there has to be lots going on in this guy's mind. Hopefully he can settle down early and pitch well in his debut.
Xander Bogaerts is in to start things out as he swings and misses at that one at strike one. The windup and the 0-1. And this ball's pretty well struck high and deep to left field. Margot's going back. On the warning track, he makes the catch. With that, here's how the hometown Red Sox line up in this one. Who do you have your eye on, Dan?
Yeah, I'm pretty excited to get a chance to watch Xander Bogaerts do his thing. He's certainly a guy to watch out there in this lineup. Everything he does makes them click. When he's swinging the bat well, they just go.
And that'll bring up the former first-rounder Christian Arroyo as he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Working the plate is Carl Dixon.
Dan, this is an offensive player's dream to have Carl Dixon behind the dish. He is tight on the corners.
He is, D-Row. And listen, he makes you bring the ball in.
Oh, this is hit high and deep out to left. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. Solo home run here off the bat of Christian Arroyo. As the Red Sox get the game's first run, it's 1-0.
Yeah, we always talk about how important it is to spot your starter or run it to early in the game, and he does just that, blasting a no-doubt bomb that serves notice. They're going to be swinging with the wood here. No better way to get the home crowd into it right out of the gates.
That is good. No left field.
And that'll bring up J.D. Martinez as he can't make contact and is tied up here at strike one. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a fastball that's taken close that time, but it's 1-1. One and two now as that one's fouled off. To two balls and two strikes now.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
And this ball is popped up, drifting back behind the mound. Choi takes charge, and he's got it. Two down.
Batting four.
Here now is Rafael Devers.
The designated hitter, Rafael.
First pitch on its way. Now the 1-0. Bases are empty here with two men out. A ball and two strikes now. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. And a slider called strike three as he couldn't pull the trigger, and the side is retired. The Red Sox do pick up a run on the solo shot. We'll head to the top of the second, and it's 1-0 Boston. And that'll bring in Yandy Diaz, as it'll be 5-6 and 7 due up to kick off the second inning.
Yandy
swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. He hit the corner and tries for third. The throw is wild, and it gets away.
Batting fifth, the left fielder.
Not to minimize the hit here, because it was a double all the way, but the wheels kind of came off defensively, and he's on third because of a bad throwing miscue.
And that'll bring up Manuel Margot. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Diaz at third with nobody out. Even 1-1 count to Margot. Fouled away.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. And the ball is dropped. And not in time as the run scores.
Yeah, it's always nice to get a run right back after you've given one up to the guys in the other dugout. So he squares this thing up really well to drive in a run and ties us up at one.
G-Man Choi the next to hit, as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. A runner at second, nobody out. I had him reaching at thin air that time, and he's very quickly down 0-2.
Hey, don't kid yourself. I know those were two bad swings, but he hits middle of the order for a reason. It only takes one swing.
And he fouls this one off.
Gotta believe that was a mislocation because it missed right down the middle. This guy's gonna have nightmares at the plate thinking about missing that one.
The 2-2. Brandon Lau, the number 8 hitter here, waits on deck. Fouled off.
Not surprised he's late on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
But quick reactions at the hot corner take away a hit, and there's one gone.
So here's how the Bo Sox are positioning themselves defensively. Hey, let me tell you about outfielder J.D. Martinez. We already know he's one of the biggest bats in the game, the ability to go deep to all parts. But I don't think people realize how good a defender this guy is. The ability to go back on the ball and a strong arm to boot.
Brandon Lau is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike one. One out and a runner on second base. Barely able to make contact. Down 0-2 now. Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes. Grounded softly to the right. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow. So a man at third here with two gone, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. One ball, no strikes to count. 1-0 pitch is a slider, swung on and missed, 1-1.
You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something clean.
He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. A run for the Rays thanks to the RBI double. On to the bottom of inning number two. All even now at 1-1. That'll bring up Bobby Dalbec. He's set to lead off the whole half of the second. The first pitch on the way.
Bobby.
And he throws the fastball by him here. 0-1.
Hey, not too often we see this hitter come outside his game plan, outside the zone, but that pitch was just so tempting.
Hit back up the middle. He's got it. And the inning begins with a quick out number one.
All right, let's take a look at the Tampa Bay Rays on defense. And let's take a look at center fielder Kevin Kiermaier, multiple Gold Glove winner, probably the most athletic outfielder in all of baseball. This guy makes the highlight reel look routine and has an absolute rocket for an arm.
Kiermaier is there, two gone.
That is tough.
The bases are empty here with two away, and that means the plug-and-play utility man Kike Hernandez will bat next. Lifted in the air to center field. On the move is Kiermaier. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Takes just four. So it's back to the top of the order now, and here comes the five-tool middle infielder Wander Franco. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. But that'll stay in the park as it's off the wall. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
One pitch, one swing of the bat, and they've got a man in scoring position just like that. On the mound, he's probably happy it stayed in the yard. He jumped all over the first thing he saw and almost got to round the bases.
Here's Randy Arozarena. So look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. Hit out towards second. Scooped up. And he will whip this one over to first in time for the out.
Now
a man at third with one away. And Austin Meadows will be the next to bat. And they start him out with a slider. Good spot, but he doesn't get the call. 1-0. And it's fouled away. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time.
They say the toughest pitch in baseball is a located fastball. I disagree. That nasty slider is tough to hold up on.
One out and a runner on third. Struck him out. And now they'll likely need a base hit to get that runner home from third.
That strikeout changes the whole complexion of the inning. He was definitely pitching for it with the runner on third and one out, and he got it. Now it's going to take a hit or something like a wild pitch to get that guy home. With the runner on third, two outs, base open, and a good hit at the plate, you have to be smart and not give in. If you walk this guy, so what? It's a lot worse if you give him a ball that he can hurt you on.
And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. More spring training baseball from Florida following this. And that'll bring up Franchi Cordero.
Leading off for the Red Sox, the center fielder.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch.
Cordero.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Yank on the ground down the line. And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. Throw into second. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Yeah, I think he was sitting on the fastball, so he got the changeup. He was way out in front of it, but he kept his hands back long enough to keep it fair down the line. That's not always easy to do.
Spin and a throw back to second, and he has to dive, but he's back in easily. In now, Jaron Duran. Bunt attempt is popped into foul ground. Ruddy with the nothing in one pitch. Bunt attempt, but this one might have too much on it. Off balance throw, but he couldn't get enough on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single.
Hey, this has the makings of being a pretty big hitting D-roll. Lead off double, now a base hit, and all of a sudden we're looking at first and third.
Yeah, sometimes you wake up, you just get smacked in the mouth right here. He's going to have to start executing pitches. He cannot leave a ball over the heart of the plate right here. He's going to have damage on his hands.
And that brings in Xander Bogaerts. High in the air out to center field. On the move is Kiermaier. He makes the catch as the runner will tag from first. The tag, and he is out at second base. It's a double play. And now a triple play as he couldn't get back to the bag, and the inning is over. So they pick up no runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left on.
Leading off for the Rays.
Yandy Diaz will stand in for the second time now as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. Popped him up. Bogaerts shading to his right. One out.
Now batting.
So next to bat will be Manuel Margot. He doubled his last time up.
Yeah, he did.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And he'll reach second now with one away.
He's been making it look real easy out there. Two at bats, two doubles. They might want to think about pitching around him the next time he steps in, because he looks locked in for this one.
G-Man Choi set the plate now as he looks at strike one. Got him out on his front foot. It's 0-2. Margo leads off second with one gone in the inning. ball, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. And now here is Brandon Lau, runner in scoring position with Cigar. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
He chases out of the zone for strike three, and that's the third out of the inning. Rays strand just the one. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth, tied 1-1. Tyler Glasnow is out from the bullpen now as he'll work in his third game so far this spring.
Tyler Glasnow.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and set to go is the third baseman, Christian Arroyo.
Third baseman, Christian Arroyo.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. And here's a ball lifted high into foul ground down the right field line. A Rosarena is over near the stands as he makes the catch for the first down.
Now the left fielder.
Here's J.D. Martinez. He's 0-for-1 thus far. First delivery to him. Swing and a miss, and he's in control. 0-2. Misses there, 1-2.
Boy, he sped him up in this at bat. Now it's time for the changeup. This guy's got a good one, and he hasn't thrown it yet in this at bat.
The 1-2. Fly ball out to straightaway right. A Rosarena is there, two down. So two gone now here in the Red Sox fourth. And that brings up the third baseman, Rafael Devers. He's set, and the pitch fouled away. A one pitch on its way, and he fouls this one off. A pause, and the 0-2 is looked at for ball one.
If I'm in the box, you take a step out right here. Take a deep breath after that high fastball. You got to be leery of him burying something in the dirt.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Three balls and two strikes to the DH for the Red Sox.
Boy, went from being in the driver's seat to now being in some trouble. Had the count 0-2, started nipping at the corners, and the next thing you know, this count stands at 3-2.
On the screws to shortstop, but caught to retire the side. Down in order go the Red Sox. Fifth inning coming up, tied at one.
Your
James Paxton,
please,
will come out now and make his first appearance of the spring.
Number 44. James.
Matt Vasgersian back with Mark DeRozan and Dan Plesac as Kevin Kiermaier settles in to start the
leading
inning.
Off for Tampa Bay.
Here's the first pitch.
Kevin
Kiermaier is in for his second plate appearance as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Here's a ball lined into left center, and that's over the head of Bogarts at short for a base hit.
Now batting.
Stepping in now, Wander Franco, as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. A ball and two strikes to the Rays shortstop. Kiermaier on at first, nobody out. Lays off the 1-2 changeup, and he's worked it back to 2-2. Struck him out, so he's set down on strikes for the second time today.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Pitch misses low. The throw down is going to be far too late. That's a stolen base.
He picked a good pitch to run on at that time, and it really paid off. A changeup down in the zone is a really tough pitch for the guy behind the plate to catch and throw on, so he didn't stand much of a chance there.
Inside and a hair low, it's two balls and two strikes. Swing and a miss. Looked like the knuckle curve there, and that's out number two. Now into the box, Austin Meadows. He went down on strikes in his last at bat. And this pitch is right down the middle, strike one. Fouled off.
On 0-2 here, he doesn't have to give in with a great pitch to hit. He's got a base open, so he has to focus on making a good pitch right here.
The 0-2, and it's fouled away. The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now. Weak grounder down the line at third, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. One. Corey Kluber, 6'4" right-hander, comes in out of the bullpen to do the pitching.
Number 30, Corey Kluber.
Stepping up is Bobby Dalbec. He'll start things out here against Corey Kluber. He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
Dalbec.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. And action now in the Tampa Bay pen as it looks like a right-hander's begun to get loose. And there's a line drive base hit to left field. So it's a leadoff base hit to start the Red Sox half of the inning. That base hit was screaming off the bat, and our show track technology more than confirms it. 111 miles an hour was the exit velocity of that line drive. And here's the catcher, Kevin Plawecki. He swings and sends a bullet to right field. But this is right at him in right field as he hardly has to move to take it in for the first down.
The batter, number five, second baseman.
So here is Kike Hernandez. He flew out in his last AB. First pitch of the AB now. Strike swinging, chased a high one there.
For most people, being down 0-1 would seem like a lot, but this guy is such a good hitter. He doesn't care going deep in the count. He's got runners on base. He has a game plan every time he comes to the plate. Let's see how this one plays out.
And here's a pitch inside, and that got him.
Wow, you want your stars to get their work in during spring training, but you don't want to see them get hit by a pitch. Looks like no damage done, though.
At the plate now, Franchi Cordero has the first pitch to him, a sinker in the dirt for ball one. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate. Down the left field line and deep. And that is off the wall, but in foul territory. Foul ball. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Back up the middle, reined in. One there, relay to first in time, and just like that, the side is retired. Red Sox lead one. We played five full, tied at one aside. Tanner Houck will come on and get some work as he makes his second appearance so far this spring. So here's Mike Zunino. Jonathan Araúz is into the ballgame as a defensive replacement. He'll be the new shortstop here. Potts will also enter as he takes over at third base.
Number 10.
Alex Verdugo is also into the ballgame as he'll assume duties in left field.
Alex Verdugo.
Jackie Bradley Jr. will also come in now as he takes over out in center.
Now playing center field, number 22, Jackie Bradley Jr.
Christian Vasquez is also into the ballgame as he'll likely go the rest of the way behind the plate.
Christian Vasquez.
Now here's the first offering. And 2-0 now as this misses below the knees.
2-0 to a guy with this kind of pop, you better be awfully careful because he's going to be swinging out of his shoes.
Too tight with that one. 3-0.
Well, ball three there. Hey, and the Rays right now, they would love to take a leadoff walk to start this inning.
3-1 the count now. Hot shot to third and handled for the first out.
The third baseman, number 2, Yandy.
Next, it'll be Yandy Diaz. 1-for-2 with a double on his line thus far. Well behind that fastball. It's a swinging strike. Sinker, and this one's over as well. Nothing in two now. One out, nobody on. Swing and a liner. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
You think there's any justice in the game? Watch those two at bats. Both of them hit on the absolute screws. One's right at one guy, and then one's a single. Go figure.
To the plate now, Manuel Margot, as he takes a cold strike at the knees. It's 0-1. He's got hits in both of his at bats so far in this one. Fouled away. Diaz leads off first with one away. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball.
It's a great job to lay off on that nasty slider right there. It's the toughest pitch. It was my toughest pitch to lay off of. I was always sitting fastball middle away, and when that slider came out, boy, did it look like a heater for a long time.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that brings up the corner infielder G-Man Choi. The 0-1 pitch. Runner aboard at first here with two gone in a 1-1 ball game. Got him swinging on the splitter that time, and with that, the side is retired. Shane Boz enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. So stepping in is Jaron Duran. He'll lead it off for the Red Sox here in their half of the sixth. And he fouls this one off. The windup and the 0-1. He looked like a caveman swinging a club on that one. It's 0-2 now.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Inside, as he might be trying to set him up here, 1-2. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup.
When a pitcher puts you in the proverbial rocking chair like he's doing right now, you have to take a deep breath. You can't start trying to guess along with him. Trust your fundamentals and stay on that fastball.
Kiermaier is there, and he has it for the first down.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Jonathan Araúz comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Action in the Rays' pen now as they've got a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. Here's a swing and a miss, 1-1. Now the pitch. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here.
Swing and a miss on a nasty slider right there. Always felt toughest pitch in the game. If you're a guy who liked to work the big part of the field, you were on that fastball middle away. That slider looked like a heater for about 56 feet, 6 inches.
Another 2-2 offering. Fouled off. One run, four hits, and one error on the Boston line score. Bat explodes as this has popped up. And there's out number 2.
That is what you're going to get when you've got a flamethrower coming out of the bullpen. And when you're late on a fastball and you make contact below the label, all of a sudden, you're holding some new firewood.
Here's the first pitch to him. Potts is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0. Well, should be 2-0, but he goes way out of the zone to go after that one, and it's even 1-1.
Ew, is that ugly? You could probably throw anything out there to this guy. He'd swing at the rosin bag if you throw it up there.
Just short, hit hard, and that's through for a hit.
I'm shocked he got to that pitch right there. In today's game of loading up, leg kicks, toe taps, dropping the hands, trying to create launch angle, that high heater usually gets by.
Alex Verdugo digging in now. Smoked on the ground up the middle. And that finds its way through for a base hit.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in. Kept his hands inside the baseball. Ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes even when you make a good pitch, the ball's going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
Into the box now, Ronaldo Hernandez, as he gets a good curveball here to start the at-bat. It's strike one. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. Comes set, the 0-1. Potts at second, Verdugo at first, two out in the inning. Grounded back up the middle, fielded cleanly, and the two-out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. Boston strands a couple. Score remains deadlocked at one. Darwin's and Hernandez is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 63.
Now it'll be Brandon Lau, struck out in his last trip to the plate. High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1.
Oh, this is what you get fired up for right here. Hard fastball against a power hitter. I know he was late right there, but if he comes back, this one might not come back.
The batter, the center fielder.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Kevin Kiermaier is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1. Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2.
I just think after seeing both those pitches right there, 96, you have to be on the fastball or you're not going to catch up. If you're sitting off speed, that fastball's going to blow right by you.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Kevin Kiermaier is the second out in the seventh inning. Francisco Mejia is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. And it's 1-2. Two out, nobody on. Got him looking, and that ends the inning. Down in order go the Rays. Matt Wisler will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh. Taylor Walls is into the ballgame as a defensive replacement. He'll be the new shortstop here. Striding in is Bobby Dalbec, 1-for-2 in the ballgame thus far. Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. This change for the Rays. Now from short.
Looked like a slider there. Number swing six. And a ball sent high in the air. This one is way back there, and it is gone. A home run. So a solo shot here to left center field, and the Red Sox move in front. It's 2-1. What a blast that was. So here it is again, accompanied by ShowTrack. Great exit velocity, and the projected distance comes back at over 470 feet. An impressive thing to watch when it happened, and even more impressive to quantify with the numbers.
Now batting, catcher.
Into the box, Christian Vasquez. As, oh goodness, not ready for that slider at all. It's strike one. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number seven. A 1-1 count now to Vasquez. Whistler typically throws a lot of strikes coming in out of the bullpen, resulting in low walk totals, although he has been snake bitten by the home run ball at times in the past.
One of the keys for this guy, Matt, is not being afraid to attack the strike zone. With that said, he is prone to giving up the home runs. I think one of the causes of that, Matty B, he leaves a lot of pitches up in the strike zone. He needs to be down in the zone when he's effective.
Nice execution right there. Ball was down below the knees. He stayed through it and was able to drive it for a base hit.
Comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. From the belt, kicks and deals. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Vasquez aboard here at first with nobody out. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Up next,
so here now is Jackie Bradley. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning.
Bradley Jr.
From the stretch. Now the 0-1. And they go right after him here as he swings and misses. Strike two. Runners on first with one down. Inside, as that perhaps will back him off a bit. 1-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time. Out number two.
One of the big advantages to pitching ahead in the count of your pitcher, because you have to cover both pitches if you're a hitter. You have to cover the off speed and the fastball. And in the 1-2 count, you might be sitting off speed. And what happens? He gets the fastball and he can't catch up to the express.
First pitch of the AB now. Jaron Duran is in for the third time as he swings and misses at that one. It's 0-1. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. One and one, here it comes. And it's fouled away. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Ground ball sent back up the middle. He's got it, and he'll go the short way to retire the side. The Red Sox tack on one more thanks to the solo home. Garrett Whitlock has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Number three will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. Now a bunt attempt here. This is foul for the first strike. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Back up the middle and in for a base hit. So it's a good start to the inning for the Rays as their leadoff hitter is aboard.
You can't ask for anything more than getting a leadoff man on right there. Brings the go-ahead run to the plate. He's in position to do some damage. It'd be interesting to see how the manager plays this one.
Strike one to start the at-bat. Both teams with 8 hits in this one. And 1-1 as this one's in on the hands. Fouled away. The 1-2. And he fouls this one off. Now another 1-2. Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
Fouled off. One and two, here it comes. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
That's a big strikeout there with the tying run over at first base. Now, with two outs, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that guy home. Probably need a fall in the gap to give him a chance.
On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. So it's number three will stick around as he'll take over in right field. Peter Fairbanks is on the pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Ford Proctor is also into the ballgame as he'll likely go the rest of the way behind the plate. Josh Lowe will also enter as he takes over at third base. Digging in, the switch hitter, Jonathan Araújo, for his career in this matchup. He's one for four. Here's the first pitch to him. Araújo, a switch hitter that stands in at an even 6 feet tall. This is his second year as a major leaguer. Here's the 1-0. Swung on and missed, 1-1.
That's just too much velocity upstairs to get good wood on it. It's going to have to lower his sights.
The 1-1 is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
When a hitter is showing he's unable to resist those inside pitches, you just might as well keep going in there and hope he keeps chasing. Those weren't strikes, but he wanted to hit them anyway.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Margo's under it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Now batting.
Next up for the Red Sox, Potts. He collected a base hit his first time up. The pitch. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike. Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. Bases are empty, one man out. A little too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. Takes this the other way to right, and that's in for a base hit, his second in as many trips to the plate.
The left fielder, number 99. Verdugo.
And the next up will be Alex Verdugo as he grounds one briskly to short. That gets through, and he'll reach base again on his second base hit of the game.
Sometimes you got to tip your cap. The pitcher spotted his pitch down in the zone right there below the knee. Offensive player was all over.
At the plate, Ronaldo Hernandez. As he'll get caught chasing a bad one there at strike one. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. Hit high and deep out to left. Margo's going back, but he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. Now the relay home.
This looked like it could have been a quick inning, get the first out, and then boom, 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 three singles. All of a sudden, they're loaded with one out.
Yeah, this is execution at its best right here. One out. He's still got double play in order. If he can make a pitch, he can get out of it. If he doesn't, crooked number goes up.
Standing in now, Bobby Dalbec. High and deep to right center. On the move is Kiermaier. He gets there to make the catch, but this should bring home a run as the runner tags from third. And that'll score the runner from third as they'll open up a 3-1 lead.
Now every team is looking for that insurance run late in the game. That run right there gives them a 2-run lead heading into the late innings.
First offering on its way. Christian Vasquez will stand in for a second time here as he swings and misses there. It's nothing and one. Well, I think his eyes lit up when he saw that pitch coming up at his eye level.
Yeah, good luck. But, hey, a high fastball.
And a slider bounces, and that gets away. And the run will score on the wild pitch. My goodness.
Man, he's out there trying to throw strikes and give his guys a chance to come back and maybe win this thing. But that wild pitch and the insurance run it allows to score certainly aren't helping matters in the slightest.
Good lead off a second there. Now the pitch. And here's a ball in the air now carrying a bit out toward right center. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. He pulls into second safely as a run will score on the play as well.
No matter.
Definitely aggressive approach here, down 0-2 in the count. Instead of shortening his swing and protecting the plate, he takes a big rip and is able to drive it deep for a couple of bases and an RBI.
Jeffrey Springs enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning. Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. 0-2 for him to this point. Comes set and the 0-1. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. Here it comes on nothing and two. Bottom dropped out on him, and that's a strikeout. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Matt Barnes takes the mound here. Not a safe situation, of course, because of the big lead, but he'll try to finish it out nonetheless. First pitch coming, here it is. Manuel Margot is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. Swing and a miss as he pulls the top hand over. It's 0-2. Oh, high, deep. That is a moonshot, folks. A long home run. Manuel Margot leaves the yard with a solo shot, and it's now a 5-2 game.
Wow, this is a tough one to swallow, right? You come in as a closer, and you're used to striking guys out and having 1-2-3 innings, and just like that, he's greeted with a bomb. Now it's time to regroup and hopefully get some outs.
In now, G-Man Choi. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Hit sharply on the ground, and he'll step on first himself for the out. Up next for the Rays, Brandon Lau. One run in and one gone so far in this inning. And a fastball misses here to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. Looked like he wanted to clobber that one, but it's 1-1. Ball and two strikes now.
This guy's got some of the nastiest stuff in the game, and it is absolutely no fun for an offense to try and piece together any type of attack when he's throwing this stuff.
One out, nobody on. Swing and a miss. Looked like the knuckle curve there, and that's out number two.
Not a lot of guys throw that knuckle curve, but some guys have a lot of success with it. Some say it has more bite than the traditional curveball, but I think it's more of a feel thing. It just works for certain pitchers, and it worked right there.
Ready with the nothing in one pitch.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Hey, this was a pretty tightly played game. Got a little bit of everything in this one. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching, and defense in certain spots. This one was a fun one to watch.
5-2, the final today. Both Sox crossed the plate three times in the eighth, helping propel them to the win. Darwin's and Hernandez earns the victory on the mound. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.